Sinking your eyes. tonight. But this time I'm going to ask Miss Shirley Appleby to come and bless us in song tonight. Thankful for that road to Calvary. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And it's because of that that we can look forward to heaven. I want you to worship the choir as we sing one that's an oldie but a goodie. I guess we say it done before. I've never been this homesick before. and sing now? Sing one of my favorites, Farther Along.
Panted and cried with a living wonder. Why it should be all the day long. While there are others living among us, now they're molested, though in the wrong. Father, understand it all, my and my.
the name that's above every other name. And we just thank you for all that you've done for us, Lord, this place. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If you want to just get seated, we're just going to sing through this. The blood of the Lord is power. Sing along with us tonight. Let's just sing this.
How can I say thanks
for the things you have done for me. Things so undeserved. And you paid to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels cannot express my gratitude. All that I hear and ever hope to be. I will go home to thee and sing a song.
Yeah.
wonderful praise tonight from one side to the other.
From Syria at the refugee camps, setting up churches and Christian schools and homes that are temporary. In 2 weeks, they'll be in the D.C. area handing out CDs, DVDs, literature to over 15,000 Iranians. And these folks, they go at it. I thought we were going to join them because I thought it was on Saturday and realized it was Sunday. We can't help, but they've got other churches that are helping them. Also, at the same time, we have a dear brother in Northern Africa, and we're able to help him in that way as well, to minister in a very dangerous area in Northern Africa, in that area of North Africa. We have literature, we buy from Bibles, you know why? And literature for Vacation Bible School for our own children. So whether it's here or around the world, listen, I know we have people from other churches tonight. Don't let anyone tell you that you cannot minister here and around the world. Don't let anyone say, well, it's only here, take care of our own, or forget about us and what about the world. God has enough to minister worldwide. What he's short on is servants. The scripture says, pray to the Lord of the harvest, he'll send forth laborers. So we're going to pray that God would take the offering, bless it, use it for his glory, and send this out. Hey, here's an idea. Fill this up. Turn us loose and make us count. But after he fills us up with himself. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our brothers and sisters all around the world who are sharing Jesus. Some of them in big crowds with no danger at all, and some of them in a hidden place and they're not sure if they're coming home or not. Others in a normal setting around the home or at school or at church sharing Jesus. Somebody in the prison ministry, the nursing home, rescue mission. A friend at school, wherever they are. Father, we're your servants. Send us out. Give us a message, Lord, in our hearts and on our lips. Grant us boldness, and that everything you give us, we'll give it right back to you, that you might bless it, and we might use it for your glory. So, Lord, do so even the offering tonight. And, Father, continue to hear our praise as we worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
extinguisher lady over there. It's a boy to play. Eric, we're so happy to have you here tonight with us. Eric and I go back about, what, about 8 years now? 8, 9 years? Oh, longer. Okay, 20 years. About it, we'll just throw it in. So, 8 and a half. Thanks. When we started putting this together, I reached out to him. He is the music minister of St. John's Baptist down in Ellicott City or Columbia? Columbia, down there. And we used to go to church together. And I just one of the best piano players I know around. And I called him, and I'm thinking, well, he won't be able to do a Sunday night. You know, won't work. I texted him. He said, yeah, I can do it. I almost crashed my car. Not that I was texting while driving. I was parked. And I still almost crashed my car. So. I'm in trouble now. Young lady, you are not a texting driver. We'll get back on track here. Again, we hope that tonight you're just going to enjoy this music. We hope you have so far. This next song the choir is going to do is just a medley of songs. If you haven't heard the one you like so far, hopefully it'll be part of this one. So just worship with the choir as we sing.
Oh,
family as they come to sing tonight. Thank you. That our past is over. Lord, we are moving forward in this place.
Thank you.
could sing. I got lucky on that one, didn't I? Those who don't know, that's my wife. Right? Just making sure there's like, what are you talking about? So, I got lucky with that one. So she's, man, what a blessing. Thank you, baby. That is the better half, absolutely. Worship with us as we sing Ivan Shelley.
Forgiven.
Oh, I feel like Job. And you know what I want to say? No, you don't. We don't have a clue. Listen, all the sheep gone, oxen gone, donkeys gone, servants gone, camels gone, all of his boys, all seven, and his three daughters gone. He tore his clothes, shaved his head, fell to the ground, and worshiped God. Blessed in the name of the Lord. Over in chapter 19, we find that Job is wanting help. And he says, my brothers are far off. My relatives have forsaken me. My friends, they've turned. My maidservant, she rejects me. My servant, I call out, and he doesn't even answer me. Well, my wife, I'm offensive to her. The little children despise me. My children even look and they're disgusted with me. And my close friends, they abhor me. My bones, my skin is clinging together. Oh, have pity on me, Joseph. Oh, have pity on me, my friends. God has stood hard and struck hard. Oh, we know nothing of Job's coming. But his Redeemer is our Redeemer. And Job says, oh, that if my words were written down, if they were inscribed in a book, if they were engraved in a rock with an iron pen and lead forever, this is what I would say. For I know that my Redeemer liveth. And at last he will stand on the earth. And after my skin has been destroyed, I shall see my God in the flesh. Amen. Hey, folks, we win. If Jesus is in your heart, you win because he wins. We know that our Redeemer liveth, and whatever fire he allows you to go through, we need to go through it with his power for his glory, that we might be a blessing to others who are going through the fire. How about you tonight? Do you have that assurance that you will see your Redeemer? Do you know without question that if you're lost at all, you still have Jesus? There are some people maybe in this room, if you lose it all, you'd have nothing. Because all you have is what you see. All you have is what you in your bank account. The car you drive, the house you live on, the clothes you wear. That's it. That's all you have. Jesus says, what would it profit a man if he gains the whole world and yet loses his own soul? And tonight, you're lost. Alienated from a loving God. And he knocks at the door of your heart. And he wants to come in. Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. Let me ask you this. In just a moment, as we sing a closing altar call type song, I wonder, do you need to come and pray and ask Jesus to come into your heart, forgive you of your sins, and take control of your life? Maybe you want to. You need to, but you need help. We'll get someone just to pray with you. Then you can just, by faith, with childlike faith, turn your life over to him. Give him everything. All that you have, all the sin, give it to him, that he might forgive you and cleanse you and bring you into his forever family. How do you do that, Pastor? You pay for it? No, he's paid for it. Work for it? No, he's done all the work. You need to obey, repent, and believe the gospel. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And tonight is your night. Behold, today is a day of salvation. Do not harden your heart. Tonight, walk this aisle. Say, Pastor, I want to be saved. Others of you, while we're singing, you might want to come and just kneel and pray for someone else. You might want to come and pray for yourself. Say, Father, I have not lived the Christian life. And Lord, I don't have a lot of time left. And I want to give you my all. And Lord, tonight I resurrender the one we've been singing about. I resurrender my life to his Lordship, Jesus, King of the universe, King of my heart. Father, hear our hearts. Hear our prayers. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Oh,
Son, take this part, honey, and get mad at us if we didn't hit it. Just the love of music, and especially Southern Gospel. We used to fight over it. Oh, I used to hate it. But I've enjoyed it tonight, and I thank you all for just letting us just worship. And I hope you have with us tonight. So let's close in prayer. And if you don't mind, we're going to close out with this hymn that we've done for many years, and a lot of hymn sings around the county with my dad, Martin Long. We'll sing How Great Thou Art. But let's close in prayer tonight. Lord, I thank you for this evening. I thank you, Lord, that we can call you Jesus and Savior. And Lord, tonight I pray that you go with us as we leave this place. Let our spirits be revived tonight as you have been in this place. Thank you for everyone here tonight. God bless us and let us share your love with others as we leave this place. In your name I pray, Lord. Amen.
Then sings my soul.
Thank you.